I'm Radhika. I am a television actress plus influencer. So, you know, whenever I interview someone, I always say, welcome to my channel. But this time, I would say, thank you for having me at such a beautiful place.
Pleasure is mine.
Yeah. So, the first question which comes to my mind, you know, when I came to this place, is like how the idea of army and the luxury thing together at a place, at a single place, comes to your mind, like came to your mind.
So, experiential hospitality is what we've been practicing for the last 10 years. I never intended to get into it at that point in time. I didn't even understand what experiential hospitality was. But now that we've been running Della Adventure Park, we create an experience. Adventure Resort, we create an experience. Then Luxury Resort, we create a luxury experience. We moved on to Candela. Candela Resort is a tent experience. Then D.A.T.A. happened into a military experience. So now we technically address this issue. How do we surprise our guests? How do we enthuse them into an environment that they've not been there before? And how do we create a very strong concept and then execute it super well? Give it 100%. Mm-hmm. So if I have 100 rupees in my pocket, I would put all 100 rupees onto creating the product. I will not worry about that out of 100 rupees, let me take 20 rupees for branding and marketing, advertising. Yeah. So for me, that is not important. Aap product mein pura dilo dimag jaan dal do. You put your 100% into the product and execute the idea with the finesse, customers will be your branding and marketing wagon. They will brand you, they'll market you, they will be your brand ambassadors like you will be. So it because if you love the product, then you will automatically do it.
Yeah,
so for me, this is super important. And if you're doing disruptive innovation, you need to understand what is not there in the market. There are hotels and hotels and hotels in the market.
Yeah.
There are jungle lodges also in India. So going into the forest and putting up a jungle lodge, it's okay. Not so that exciting.
Yeah.
But giving it a military theme is exciting. Yeah. Military theme resort, we are the only one in the country. It doesn't exist. Second, training. Only boot camps are there. There are army training camps are there, which is hardcore regimental training. We didn't want that because that's not what you and I want. What we want is, yes, we want to be trained, but we want to be trained in a more sophisticated manner, which doesn't exist in India. So you pick up the best trained personnel, especially from the army, and organize the training. You modulate the training program. So I've sat down for 2 years with these boys and made a program. A generalist got on board and refined the program. So our program has never been, because army training is very different. When they, the background they come from, they either know how to kill or to survive. They don't know how to train somebody PRC on techniques. So, and our training is all about techniques. It's not about the physical strength. It's not about allowing you how to attack or defend. The whole idea is to train you on techniques. So if you are in an environment, either a terrorist attack or a natural calamity, how do you survive?
The other thing which excited me is, you know, when I got to know that the commando is real commando, they are from real army background.
Not just army background, they are all special forces.
Yeah, exactly.
Special. So special, so, see, within the army, there are too many divisions and departments. Artillery, and within artillery, you have your special forces. Special forces are hand-picked people who go out there and launch the attacks and come back, go out there and do search and rescue operations, come back. So they are special forces. So within the army also, they're the hand-picked best.
Yeah.
And they have done multiple assignments. So our people have done assignments in Somalia at the UN. They've done assignments in Kashmir for counter-insurgency operations. And they've been to Ladakh and they've been in multiple operations across. Some of them are ID specialists. Some of them are specialists across who have been specializing in the valley. And hence the level of knowledge. Our general, Lieutenant General Raymond Narona, he's a man who set up the Mountain Task Force against China. So the kind of strategy that they deployed at that level. Imagine our corporates getting to learn that strategy.
Yeah.
How did he strategize a million soldiers? So that kind of learning, or you meeting a commando who was the first 8 respondent, Marcos commandos in Taj attacks. So he has been there, done that. Now he has got a right to come and teach.
But how did he manage to get them through?
Well, if you have will, there is a way. And everything is not self-learned on day one. You start working on and you get hiring people and you get meeting people and talking and people get to hear about you, what you're doing, and they are interested in joining you. Now a lot of special forces come to me and say that, yes, we want to be a part of your team. So it's a two-way track. It happens. On day one, no concept is all end-to-end, foolproof, ready to go.
Yeah.
Each stage, you take it as it comes, and you are humble enough to say, okay, I'm learning. Like I keep saying, I don't have a problem, I'm learning. Hospitality, 10 years also, we are still learning.
I mean, there are established brands who've been there for 50 years or 40 years or 30 years. They are giants. We are just learning. They've got 100 hotels. We've got one. Six resorts. We're just learning. Yeah, but
somewhere
down
the line,
it's okay. The people have got 100 resorts. So we are very small and we are learning. But in doing so, we are also a strong brand that remains true to its essence and creates experiences for guests.
Okay. So what's your inspiration actually? Like, you know, when you started up this, who inspired you and you're like, yeah, I want to do this?
So there is no single individual who's an inspiration.
Okay.
But yeah, in our overall business philosophy, Jamshedji Nasarwanji Tata, the founder of Tata Group, and J.R.D. Tata then, they have a write-up in Tata Group which holds good, and I hold it absolutely true in my life. No success or achievement in material terms is worthwhile unless it serves the needs of the country and its people and is achieved by fair and honest means. So any business you do, if it doesn't serve the needs of the people in some form,
yeah.
and is achieved by fair and honest means, that is not success. Then you're just increasing your balance sheet. You might be another moron.
Yeah.
You might be making 100 crores, 1000 crores, 10,000 crores, it's all the same, because if you're not adding value to the country and its people, that business is, I mean, it's not a successful business as far as they were concerned,
yeah.
and as far as I'm concerned. So for me, this is the single most important thing. So Della Adventure creates happiness, gets families together, does bonding, creates local employment. We've picked up passionate locals and made them into professionals over here of what we do, of various activities. We've adopted 160 children, Adivasi kids in our nearby school, are mentoring those kids on everything from archery to shooting to mountain climbing to teaching them education, hired teachers and professors. So for us, business is important.
Yeah.
Making two bits of money is also important. But if whilst doing that, if you're doing all the other things, that's equally or even more important at times. So our whole local environment has been changed because of what we are doing here. We've got about 900 locals who are working with us. 900 families are supported. We made them professional. Somebody's become a housekeeping manager. Somebody's become from a gaonwali bai to a chambermaid. And she's in a uniform nicely coming to a office, swiping a thumb, which she had never imagined.
That's a great change.
So that's the kind of social change that
yeah.
ticks me. So the motivation you were talking about, for me, that's my motivation. When I see the gardeners working instead of doing khetiwari, they are wearing a uniform and working and doing gardening, have a respectable job. When they have a trouble at home, we are there to support them. So that's the kind of social responsibility on our shoulders. And yes, in doing so, we are also running a business, which is...
As I asked, like, who's your inspiration, and I'm sure, like, 100 of people who are watching you, now you are their inspiration.
I really believe that. Thank you.
So yeah, that's
they are welcome to connect to me at any point in time. They are welcome
for
to
sure.
get on my Insta, my FB, and send messages,
yeah.
and I'll make sure that I guide them and reply to them. And
so,
it's a pleasure talking to
same
you.
Same. Thank you so much.
Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.